the TEDx prism of possibilities, and we are really honored and privileged to share the stage, especially with the great personalities today. And thank you, NHL Municipal Medical College, for inviting us to this wonderful event. So, I'm Sanjay Oza, 58 years old. A singer-composer by profession and in the field of music since last, say, more than 30 years. Thank you. By the grace of Almighty, I was born to two culturally rich and music lovers and the lovers, Uma Oza and Mahesh Oza. So it all started then. Thank you, Ma and Papa, for having me. My mother, Uma Oza, see, we'll be sharing the thoughts and the experiences which we feel like worth sharing today. So, Jeevan Yatra and Emma Baneli, Kitlik Vato, I share Karishu. To start with, my mother, Uma Oza, she was a wonderful singer of her times, very melodious. Even today, she is confined to bed, unfortunately, now. But even today, when she murmurs the forgotten lyrics and the broken tunes and by broken voice, I love her voice. I used to attend all her concerts whenever and wherever she performed. She used to perform devotional music, Garba, and Gujarati Sugam Sangeet. I learned a lot from that. Shravan, Sabhavan, listening, e apro pello ane hamesh no guru chhe. You all know that. My father, Professor N.B. Oza, Mahesh Oza, was a professor of English literature and music and art lover. We would sit for hours together and talk about the different art forms of music and cinema and drama and books especially. He was not a singer. He was not a Tansen, but he was a Kansen. And he was a good astrologer as well. So he predicted my passion and profession and never ever stopped me to where I was destined to go. Koipan sari shaikshanik shala ke college hoy, they provide good cultural ambience as well, je mari shala and my college did to me. So, from the stage of the Kalfest and the talentees of St. Zimmer's College, I started performing commercially the popular Hindi music. I started learning from Honorable Krishnakant Parikji of Mewati Gharana. It was a splendid experience, believe me. I was a part of the choir group, choral group of All India Radio. Samuh Gaan, ek vishisht paddhati chhe, ma ek chokkas dhara dhurun thi gaavanu hoy chhe. Ane, you learn a lot. I was fortunate enough to be a part of the Akashpani choral group Ahmedabad. Great training. But the commercial aspects of singing in the studio, learning a tune, grasping it quickly, and reproducing it according to the requirement of the music director and the customer, maybe a producer, that art was taught to me by Honorable Music Director Gaurang Vyasji. He's a big name in this field, even today. So with all these experiences, it was the cassette industry then. Cassette to do it for New York, Tamil Karaj. Our museum was more or less a little audio cassette industry. So lot many albums were being produced and I was a part of that industry, lot of singing. So with all these experiences, I pushed off to Mumbai, Swapnagari, city of dreams, where survival itself is an experience for an outsider. Mumbai, I worked with different composers and different organizers, and it was a great experience, getting through this. Mari abadi je kai pravruti hati singing nahi. That was being observed, I was unaware. that was being observed by a big organizer in New York City. And I was invited there to perform. I divided my art of singing into different segments. So it was film music, it was non-film music, it was documentaries, ad films, drama, devotional music. And then came the wave of Garba. I was never a Garba singer, believe me. I never intended to sing Garba because I felt that I was a star of a recording studio. But I realized the relevance of Navratri festival in the lives of the Gujarati people. Believe me, wherever they would go, they would love to start doing Garba. So I, why not? I thought so, and I started, I formed a group, and I started the Garba concerts. So then it was the invitation in 1996 to the United States of America, and along with my group, I started performing there. So it was commuting between Ahmedabad, Mumbai, and US. Along with that, there was one more passion. I'm fond of reading poetry. Kavya Pathan Manakut Galansi. And I started composing music. So that is the basic music today. And it's very important. We have Shastriya Sangeet, but light music is India film music. So we need to develop that particular part. So, believe me, the composing a tune and singing was a great satisfaction to me, even today it is. There I was completely aware that I am being observed by a wonderful person in my life, and that was Parth. He was growing with his own ideas and ambitions, and he was observing me every bit, every moment, and came out as a better singer now, as you all know. So that was the pace of my life during those days and even today. Learning, practicing, performing, singing for different composers, meeting different people, learning day by day, every moment. Mara char guru hata. I had four gurus. One, Ma, my mother. Second, Krishna Kanji. Third, Gaurang Vyasji. Fourth, all the composers that I sang for. And now, I have a fifth guru even today, and that is the new generation singers. I enjoy observing them. I, as a listener, I cherish, and as a singer, I learn from them. And it's something wonderful. I love observing your path.
Likewise, Dad. I have been observing him throughout my life, and that is why I'm here, basically. So thank you for that first. Essay that a journey has a lot of words, a journey has a lot of moments, a journey is a bundle of lots and lots of experiences, which, of course, to deliver out at this point of time is a little tricky. But I might highlight a few points out of it. So as a kid, I started learning at a very tender age. But my first musical encounter was that my dad made a lovely arrangement at home. A sir used to come, and he used to teach me and my sister the simplest of Gujarati songs of children, Baal Gito, Mara Prabhu to Nana Che. I think this is not Spanish, okay? This is Gujarati. So these were the lovely, lovely, lovely tracks which we used to learn as kids. And I think it was the best part because we had a lovely time. Simplest pleasure of learning these simple songs which were of different climates, different festivals, different moods, different colors, different animals. And now I think that there might be two reasons. First, to instigate the correct musical instinct within me with a pleasure and not with a force. And probably second, that my dad wanted to celebrate the triumph that, yay, I had the genes of music in me. But of course, the continuation of learning is always there. I'm going to give a little brief about my aspects of learning music and my musical encounters in life. So I started learning Indian classical music, Hindustani classical music at the age of five.
If I'm not mistaken.
And that too from the same Guruji, Pandit Shri Krishnakant Bhai Parikh. So we are maintaining the legacy in that too. And he was a very, very, very enlightened guru, but a very strict guru, because he always wanted and intended that I used to practice and I used to do riyaz every day. At the time when even I did not know what was riyaz. So that was the time and that was the pleasure of learning. But I did put a prerequisite in front of Guruji and Dad, that I will learn Indian classical music, but I don't want to give any exams of that. They agreed. And the act of learning was simply pleasurable. Or probably some, now when I go back, I think that just on a lighter note, God might have come and told me that please don't memorize all these sarkams and Indian rags right now. You have anatomy, physiology, biochemistry, a lot of things to get memorized. But yes, that's how this entire phase of learning developed. One more angle which I would like to add is that for any child or for anybody to be into the field of music or in fact any field of art, there has to be a shelter, there has to be a shell, there has to be, as far as music is concerned, the musicality to be developed in the most accurate manner right from your childhood. And it doesn't happen with just one instance or one incident or with few of the talks, a few of the learning episodes. It's a bundle. You pile up these experiences, you pile up these observations, you pile up these unconscious notations which are happening in your life around, and that forms your musicality. Basically, a lot of dots here. So we need to maintain the neural knots in the brain that are musical enough so that you can implement music actually when you're performing. Few of the highlighted aspects of it I would like to present here. So maybe I was really blessed, and I'm still blessed and thankful, that I'm born into a musical family. So the importance of such a thing is that right from the childhood, the music that comes to your ears is a filtered music. Certain type of music is automatically filtered and your ears perceive only quality form of music. So that becomes your preferences. Those are your choices. And in the future, you have certain limitation and certain a good limitation, a positive limitation of what you want to impart and implement as a musician. Probably every day's mahal of riyaz at home, when Dad used to sing and we used to cherish, probably those musical notes and those sur that kept on hammering in my brain either. Strangest, but I would like to share it here. I have been told, and I have seen some pictures also, wherein the concert is going full-fledgedly, ekdam dhoom dhadam, and I am shanti se sleeping on the corner, on the stage. Probably this might also be one of the reasons that subconsciously I am perceiving music when the concert is full on, in its full josh. Every day going garba on Dad's tunes during Navratri, while I am dancing, I am perceiving that music, I am perceiving those tunes, and it happens even now that there are certain tunes, there are certain songs which probably I just murmur out, it comes out from my brain anytime, and Dad is astonished that how come you are singing this song? I said, I don't know, Dad, because such songs are not available on any of the online mediums. I might have heard it years before, but then it pops up, it comes out and I sing. So these are a few of the elements probably. And we should also not forget the failures, because certain failures in certain field will always enhance the positivity in the field which you are in. So failed attempt to learn professional cricket, failed attempt to learn basketball, failed attempt to learn swimming, I'm talking about me. And all of these things happened with a focus that the music got enhanced every day. I think that was the reason why this entire musical shelter that was formed around me and within me. Of course, one thing I would like to mention is that as a child, we all used to attend various musical concerts, interacting with the musicians, interacting with the people who attended workshops, musical workshops, one-to-one, learning them, observing them, seeing them, how do they perform, getting fascinated by them. These are all also a few of the added points that add up and make the musicality. One more thing which I learned was, I learned the importance of puberty in my life. Guys, everybody learns it. But there is one change which happens, is your voice changes in the males. Am I right or wrong? So, that was a very conscious awareness which I got to know. That my Guruji told me two things. That either you have to sing too much, or you have to sing less. So that your voice gets molded in a correct manner. I chose to sing less. The pleasurable side effect, superb marks in 12th, and a government medical seat in Rajkot. The pleasure is equivalent, because I was here a couple of days before speaking the same, that studying medicine was a pleasurable intention. It was never by force. It was thoroughly by choice. And I still enjoy every day of my medical life. But I thank my medicine in another way. Because those 5.5 years of my medicine triggered that fire, that passion within me, wherein I could see myself performing on the stage in front of thousands of people. And that was going to be a reality, which I came to know later. But then, that was just a dream. I had to put it in reality. And post-internship, when my entire batch of friends were studying for post-graduation examination, I was with a happy smile going around here and there, but searching for something which I intended to do in my life. Two things. One, I was knowing that entering into the professional world of music is not an easy task. So, hard work was the only policy which I had to follow. I knew that my brain was asking for more musicality, more riyas, more practice, not many more things into it, and I did that. I initiated that. Of course, I am thankful enough that I got a lovely platform from my dad. But at the same time, I was very sure that this platform comes with responsibilities. Responsibility of maintaining the legacy. Responsibility of enhancing what he has already created and putting forth into the world with a new dimension, with a new arena. Now, at this stage, whatever little I do, maybe singing on the stage, in live shows, playback singing in films, getting music videos out, acting as an actor in few films, doing music and utilizing music in the form of therapy either. Probably this is just a preface of my life. I'm still to create loads of experiences, loads of intonations, and loads of different thoughts pertaining to what I do and what I will be implementing as a professional in my life. I still consider myself to be that school kid. A school kid who has a school bag full of observations in which I keep on adding them every day. I still consider myself as a school kid who's building blocks of his own musicality. I'm still that little kid who draws with a pencil to widen his horizon of music. Because I think for every day for me is a new day, is a new challenge. It is a new day of abundance. It is a new day of new discovery. It is a new day of seeing a dream again. It is a new day for defining hard work and passion in probably more creative manners. It is a new day to smile always and think that life is beautiful. I think this is my style and this is my attitude there.
Attitude ni jyare vaat chhe tyare thodi Gujarati attitude apne. Are you going okay? Tame thodi musical kariye.
हे रंग लो जन का रंग छोड़ा तारा ओए चला तारा ओए रंग ला तारा रंग फेरू तारी रात रंग लो हितने એતને જાતા જોઈ પણ ઘટની વાટે મારું મન મોહી ગયું એતને જાતા જોઈ પણ ઘટની વાટે મારું મન મોહી ગયું મારું મન મોહી ગયું મારું મન મોહી ગયું એતને
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
You talked a lot about everything, but I have a comparison thari jaye che. The time when I had started, even today I perform by God's grace, but when you started, to ek bae samay gaala ma ek difference che Parth, ke during those days, all the artists had lesser platforms, lesser openings. Today we have social media, we have FM radios, TV channels, and whatnot. We can project ourselves whenever and wherever we want, isn't it?
Absolutely, but there is an addition along with this, that since there are so many mediums for us to portray whatever we have, the challenge is that how do we filter? Everybody can put anything, but then there has to be a filtration of what is good and what is little good, lesser good or poor maybe. That bifurcation is turning ultimately into a very strong competition right now, a cutthroat, a stress-induced competition, I suppose. But of course, there is always a thought that whenever, because it is now, right now, the zone is all about scrolling up and down. It's just in a moment and a fraction, thing comes and thing goes.
With everything said and done, it's the power of music, which we feel every moment. Believe me, all my relationships in my life are musical. My parents, they gifted me music. My sister, she supports me because she loves my music. My wife, she was in love with me because of my voice. I hope still she is. My Gurujis, mari kala emne parkhi ane mane shiksha aapi. My children, Devki and Parth, great music lovers, and Parth is out to conquer the world with the same sword I used. And all my fans and friends, those who love my voice and put trust in me. I love them all, and they are the force of life. We feel the energy every moment, while practicing, while performing, while even listening to the music. So whenever jarepan I come, khelayavano dariyo jare navratrimao gatavane mari same hoy, tare combination dije energy emerge thai chane, that keeps us going, isn't it right?
That energy, comes to one point that music, just imagine logically, it is the simplest tool to derive pleasure in your stress-induced arenas. Am I right or wrong? That is the basis of stress reduction therapies and few of the intended therapeutic applications of the subject which I would intend to make it more and more brighter, that is music as a medicine. I was fortunate enough to club music in the form of holistic healing and making it a complementary medicine. And I'm sure that there are a lot of medicinal brains sitting in the audience. This is a form of holistic medicine and a form of complementary medicine wherein definitely Indian history has got loads of observations. But it is time for us to make it more and more evidence-based. And that's what my practice is, and I'm sure that that's where the support of this budding medicos is going to be added upon.
And last but not the least, whenever I'm asked to say something to the newcomers and the singers, upcoming freshers, I would say that plan and perform is the key. Aajna zamana ma khas karine to apne je apni ghatmaal je jeevan ni che happenings of our life ema sahaj rite vahi javu ek sari vaat che pan atyarna zamana ma apni ichcha pramane અને આપણી જરૂરિયાત પ્રમાણે આપણી કેડી કંડારવી એ અનિવાર્ય બની જાય છે. સો યુ પ્લાન એન્ડ પરફોર્મ, ધેટ શુડ બી ધ કી.
એન્ડ વન કી વિચ આઈ લર્ન ફ્રોમ હિમ ઇટસેલ્ફ ઇઝ ધ કી ધેટ વોટ સો એવર ધ સિચ્યુએશન ઇઝ, બી જેન્યુઇન, બી ટ્રુ ટુ યોર સેલ્ફ ઇન ઓલ ધ ફીલ્ડ્સ, વોટ એવર યુ વર્ક ઓન. એન્ડ આઈ થિંક ધ લાઈફ ઇઝ ગોઈંગ ટુ શો યુ ધેટ સ્પાર્કલ, ધેટ બ્રાઇટનેસ, which I'm sure about it, and believe me, sabka time aayega.
show the attitude of some Hindi as well.
Absolutely. I think we should end it musically. Right?
Yes.
Hey, Inaminadika.
Inaminadika.
Hey, Dai Dominica.
Dai Dominica.
Hey, Makanakanaka.
Makanakanaka.
Hey, Chikatikarika.
Chikatikarika.
Inaminadika. Hey, Dai Dominica. Makanaka, Makanaka. Chikatikarika. Rampampos. 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 Is pe bhoot koi chada hai, par na janana. Ab to kya bura kya bhala hai, fark pehchanna. Zip pakad ke khada hai kambat chhodna janana. Badtmeez dil, badtmeez dil, manna manna. Badtmeez dil, badtmeez dil, badtmeez dil, manna. Thank you again. It was an honor and privilege to be here with you all. It was a wonderful time. Thank you so much.
Thank you.